Let me remind you that we are trying to connect the MP3 module to the tape deck. We want to use its amplifier and speakers to listen to music from the MP3 module. The idea was to take power from the power supply of the tape drive DC motor. However, if we do that, we will get a surprise. Let's listen to what we get if we just connect the module instead of the DC motor. Power on. Do you hear the noise? I think it happens because ground and audio ground of the tape deck have a different potentials. This phenomenon is known as a ground loop. See Wikipedia for details. Therefore, parasitic current begins to flow through the MP3 module. It contains high frequency noise, which spoils the audio. I'll show you how to remove interference and noise in the audio signal. We can act in two ways to solve this problem. We will apply galvanic isolation. We can isolate power, or we can isolate audio signal. Isolation involves the use of transformers. I will show you how to make a galvanic isolation of the power supply. For me, it is a cheaper option. But at first, I tell you how to make galvanic isolation of the signals. We will need an audio transformer for each channel, so you need two audio transformers. You can buy them at eBay or AliExpress, or you can also take it from the old modems. For example, my old US Robotics voice modem. Here it is. And DSL modem. This guy is our audio transformer. Audio transformers usually have a ratio 1:1 and a specific impedance. You can buy a ready-made assembly. Search for ground loop isolator. Further approach is related to using high voltages, which if not handled properly can lead to death. Do everything at your own risk. If you are a beginner, use galvanic isolation of signals, no power. Audio module operates at a constant voltage. The allowable range from 7 to 12 volts. I have a switching mode power supply. This is a battery charger for my phone, which is fed from an AC supply with an input AC line voltage of 230 volts and 50 Hz, and which provides a constant stabilized 5 volts. It already has a transformer. I had to change the design a little bit. I soldered Zener diodes in series to raise the output voltage. Now it's about 8 volts and it is suitable for my audio module. But again, you can buy ready-made DC power supply at eBay. It will cost you a few bucks. Let's try to start our module with the power supply and see whether there are any interference.
В Одессе жил, купался в море я черном, знали на пляже все меня. Куплеты пел, играть умел на гитаре, любовью я играл, шутя карты.
As we can hear, there are neither interference nor noise. It remains to solder the input of our DC power supply directly to the socket of the cassette deck that connects to the power cable. DC power supply is small and fits easily in the body of our cassette deck.